Hi, I'm Lori, and today I want to show you how to paint this reflective pond on mini canvas in black and white. The supplies that you will need are shown right here: the reference photo, two types of acrylic paint, titanium white and carbon black, one mini canvas, three paint brushes, one flat, wider brush, one detail brush, and one finer detail brush, a palette to mix your paint, some paper towel, and a cup of water.
Okay, I'm going to start with doing this guy, and it's just mostly titanium white with the slightest hint of carbon black, just to give it a little bit of color, not much at all. And so the sky is, it stops about halfway down the canvas. And then there's some reflection of the sky right about here on my reference photo. So might as well just block that in now and then let it dry and put in more detail around it. So it's okay if there's some streaks in the sky, because that's what really faint clouds do in the sky. It doesn't look like much yet, but now I'm going to use my fine detail brush. I'm going to get it wet, take a little bit of the water off the brush, and then go right for some pretty dark color, so mostly carbon black and a little bit of white. And I'm going to block in the horizon, sort of on this body of water. It's actually looked like a bit of a man-made lake that we were visiting close to the ocean on the big island of Hawaii. It's a beautiful spot. And there were just a lot of tropical foliage in the background. See, that's what happens right there when the white paint isn't quite dry. And I'm not too worried about it, because this doesn't have to be completely black back here. Normally I would let that layer dry, that white layer dry, but I'm just going to fill in this area mostly, not too carefully anyways. Now, and I can always put some dark spots where I want them after this coat dries. And there's this cool little valley place where I get to put some really distant palm trees above here. And then there's some foliage of a nearer tree showing up right here. Just need to get a layer of that on, and then I'll put another layer of it on when that dries. So there's also a nice dark water reflection here, and it's just a black, a little bit of titanium white, very smudgy around the edges especially. And so I'm just kind of blocking in the same mirror image shape basically that happened above the waterline, and just trying to make it a bit fuzzier. Try not to make the edge very defined, just really smudgy. That's what water reflections do. They just kind of look really blurry, but in the same general shape as what's going on above the water. So now that I got that edge in, even just a little bit more to mirror image this and this, and this and this. Doesn't have have to be exact because the water ripples and does funny things, so I can take my wider brush and fill that in. A much wider brush, and I just want to leave a few little white spots showing through on this line so I can keep track of where the water's edge was a little bit. Kind of like that. Fill that in, fill that in, fill that in. Okay, and so now I can also get the foreground, the grassy bank, marked in, blocked in here. Kind of comes up a bit, and there's a little bit of a downturn and then an upturn again, and then it just keeps coming across like that. And don't forget to paint around the edges. Makes a really nice finished piece when you do that. I'll do that off camera. And now I'm going to block in the tree that's in the foreground. So I'm going to use a gray so I can differentiate it between this area here. So there's a big branch that goes that way and that way. It's a really unusual looking tree. I think it's a banyan tree. It reminded me of the arbutus trees that I live near on the west coast of Canada. But these are just gnarly and interesting trees, but their bark is really dry, and that in that way quite different than an arbutus tree, but I like the shape of them. I'm just going to lighten the color of what I'm blocking in down here so I can see where I'm painting it in relation to what's in behind it. I just have a pile of gray mixed on my palette, and I'm now just kind of dipping into whichever color will show up against whatever backdrop I'm painting on. So down here I'm going into more of a bit of a grayer color so I can see it. And up here it doesn't really matter because it'll show up no matter what color it is. I'm just blocking in the extents of it right now anyways. I can always fix little details of it later after this layer dries. So that's pretty much what's going on with the tree on this side. And then it breaks off into another really gnarly branch. That's kind of broken off right there. And there's a branch that keeps going. I need wetter paint. If my paint's nice and wet and I twist my paintbrush around in my on my canvas or on my palette, I can get a thinner line. Even with a really rough brush like I have. This isn't the best brush, but sometimes I just make do with what I have in my hand. Now I'm gonna go for a bit lighter gray so I can see it against this this backdrop. Branch right there. Just really want to block this in and get it in as quickly as possible so I can start putting in some details. But that's pretty much where it it sits on the canvas. Sure, that's good. And so now I'm just going to take almost completely charcoal black, actually carbon black, and just use the tip of my paintbrush to make some pounces on the canvas to show that there's some leaves up there. And if I put lots of paint on my brush and just touch the canvas super lightly, it actually makes some pretty nice leaf shapes without a lot of fuss. I just have to pay attention to how much space I leave between the leaves. Some places I want space and some places I don't. I want it to be pretty random looking, just like nature does. And then I want some to be kind of trailing down from up there. And I want a few to be back here. Just some really, 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 really small ones. So to do small ones, you have to water down your paint quite a bit, roll it around in the paint to make a nice tip on your brush, and then a super, super light touch on the canvas to make the finest little dots with just a few of the hairs on the brush. And then I press a little harder for bigger dots, bigger leaves. And then lots more paint, and just a very light touch for even bigger leaves. So it's fun just to kind of play around with the brush that you happen to have in your hand and see how it works. See what shapes it naturally makes. Sometimes I do leaves with a knife edge brush and just use the corner of the knife edge brush. But because this one's in my hand, I'm just going to use this one. There's definitely some bigger ones. Must be closer to the camera over here. Paying attention to kind of where they are concentrated generally, and trying to follow a little bit of what my reference photo is showing me. But it doesn't have to be perfect. Just close enough to... Yeah, you just learn so much from each reference photo that you look at. Really look at it and really try to see what's there. And there's some leaves that were kind of dangling off a different branch over here. So I just want to make sure and not forget. Few of these ones bigger and closer together, just to make them look a bit more random. And some really tiny ones in between. And then there's some kind of neat plant on the shoreline right here with leaves kind of trailing down. I'm not sure what this plant is, but its leaves are pointing down like that. So I'm just going to put some of those in. Some have absolutely no light shining through. And some have a lot of light shining through. And there's ones that are all by themselves out here. You can use the finer detail brush to shape some of them on the perimeter. If you shape just some of the perimeter things that you're painting, your eye will fill in the rest. because those just look like blobs right now, but I'll fix that in a bit. Okay, so I'm going to do some of that perimeter stuff that I was talking about. So for example, I'm going to use a really fine detail brush in my darker gray colors, and I'm going to show you how I can make this look like grass just with a few touches on the edge. So I don't have to put much detail, but just on this one perimeter edge, make it look like grass, like just a few blades of grass, and then instantly your eye knows that, oh, this whole area is filled with grass blades, even though I'm only painting in this edge. And so then if I use a lighter color, I can do another line of grass blades right here. And I can even make it a bit lighter. And doing the strokes up would be better. So they end on a point. Needs to be watered down more so that I can really have a nice pile of watery paint that I can just quickly dip into. Do these quick little grass strokes like that. Some are more like plants than just blades of grass. And if I go lighter and lighter and lighter, then it gives it depth and interest. Sort of go from dark to medium to light, usually. And fill in an area quite nicely. With detail. What I'm trying to say. Depth and detail. I want to give the impression in this really far background that these are tropical plants and things, so I'm going to give the impression of palm trees with this little fine detail brush. Palm trees kind of do this at the top, kind of go every which direction in a little bit of a light gray, because when colors fade off into the distance, they literally fade. And then that gives the eye the indication that it's in the distance. And then there was a bunch kind of clumped together in this part. I should try to do them a bit lighter. Kind of look like stars a little bit, and then they just have one line, one really thin line for their trunk, and gives a bit of an impression of those palm trees. And then along the shoreline on that far side, there were some more banyan trees that you just see a glint of some of their trunks. Just kind of showing up back there. So I'll put a few of those in. The paint is getting quite sticky being acrylic paint, so I need to add water. Just have some foliage there, and then some foliage here. So I'm just pouncing around with just the tiniest little touch, just to fill in sort of where the light is shining on this part of the foliage. And this paint will darken as it dries. I have to be careful that I'm not starting too dark. There's some. Yep, just looking at my reference photo and looking for just little shadows and bits of light that are bouncing off parts of the foliage back there. And I'm just looking for abstract shapes of those things, and I'm just repeating them. I'm just drawing them like I see them to a degree, you know, not too worried about doing it exactly, but just paying attention to what's over there and then trying to copy it somewhat. And then there's a bunch of branches that I didn't draw in, paint in. Very branchy tree. It's going every which way. A lot of them coming down from the top, curving around. Again, I need super watery paint for this part. Rolling the tip of my brush around. These fine little details at the tip are sometimes the most important details to get right. Like just on the edges of things, to get those ones accurate. And like these ones that are disappearing off in the distance, make sure they're nice and hair like just super super thin, just disappearing off in the distance. So I'm not going to paint in nearly anywhere near as many as are showing on my reference photo, but gonna get some of them in, because man, there's a lot. There's a bunch that go off into this distance here. And there's some in front of the foliage here they actually, the branches appear almost white. I'm trying to get a pile of nice light gray paint too. Nice watered down gray paint to do these little branches that gives the light is shining off them differently. Going that way, that way. I may not have to do so many of these. You gotta sometimes just stop. And I'm not stopping, I'm still doing more branches. So a trick I do to trick myself into stopping doing so much detail is I actually step back and I look into the iPhone that I'm recording on, and if I like what I'm seeing on the iPhone screen, then I just stop no matter what. My eye is still picking up in the reference photo, so now I've done that, and so now I'm gonna start working on a different part of the painting. Because I've definitely done enough information on the tree and the leaves and the branches that it's doesn't need any more. Just taking it too far. So I need to move on to a different part of the painting. It's really easy to get stuck and just keep painting over and over and over again, and really it's not necessary on these little canvases. And your eye is so smart, picks up so much, fills in so many of the gaps of what we don't paint on a painting. Doesn't have to be perfect. So what really stands out to me is that all of these tree trunks that are showing up above the water also show up as mirror images below the water. So I'm going to try to do some of those. And then they end up really streaky down there as well. There's some like just random streaks. So I'm going to try to get most of these mirror image ones in first, and then I'm looking now for the random streaks that show up on the reflection. And like, yeah, there's some random streaks. Those are too big. I'm gonna have to paint over that. Let that dry and do my random streaks. Not so dark. Okay. Let's work on this section for a minute. Some more little grass strokes in this area, marking where the tree trunk begins and where the grass ends. Like a nice, really, really thin white. Direction. My paint is really gummy. I need to really water it down well and make a nice pile of light paint. Rolling my brush around so it's not all stuck on as a blob, but as a nice thin amount of paint. Like that. So one of the coolest sections on this whole painting is sort of a little ripple in the water that I really want to try to get to. So it is down here. Knowing that the paint's going to dry darker, I need to use a bit lighter of a gray. And right now I'm really looking at the abstract shape of this gray patch on the water. I'm just trying to do the same abstract shape that I see on the reference photo. And it does this, and then it just filled in a bunch of gray back here like that. Like that. These edges are could be a little bit smudged. A different color gray. Like that. And there's a really, 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 really light little abstract shape back here. And I'm just trying to copy. And same with over here. And then it just kind of blends on this edge in a few spots. And then there was just a little bit of smudge or something along here to show that it's a water reflection and not the actual trees. That's a little smudge, might have been a bit much. Sometimes these smudges have to actually have a vertical feel to them to seem more like reflections. And on the reference photo, for some reason, there's a bit of a spot that sticks down lower than the rest, so I'm just going to put that in there, just trusting that should be in there like that. And now I might, oh yeah, there's more to that rippled area that I have to add in with my really fine detail brush. So the ripple this just keeps rippling. This is a tricky shape I'm trying to paint for the ripple. Don't quite have it right. These leaves in too soon, because now they're kind of getting in my way. This nice ripple. This should be way thinner. So the nice thing about acrylic paint is that you can use other colors to erase spots that you shouldn't have painted. So I'm just using the white as an eraser right now. Proportions of this ripple have to be pretty true to what's on the reference photo, or it won't look like anything. Hmm. like a ripple, but not much. Yeah, this is tricky. To let that area dry and then come back to it, I think. So I'm just gonna work on some edges over here. Just kind of roughing up the edges a bit. Some really fine little ripple lines over here. Just a couple around the perimeter here as well. Kind of really helps your eye to realize that that is water. An interesting ripple effect as well as reflection. So it's kind of working. Now if I could just get that ripple right, then the rest of it would all come together really well. I'm going to paint up some more of this. Gonna have to let that dry before I can come in and fix it some more. Actually starting to look a bit like a ripple from a distance. Maybe a little bit more white. Right about here might help. I'm going to work on the really rough bark of this tree. It has some beautiful little cracks and crevices and things. So I'm just using a really, really fine detail brush to put in a few of those to help this stand out the way that it stands out in the image. Showing all those beautiful rough parts of the bark. And where the light's catching it. Just seems to be on the one side of the branches. I love this little brush when my paint is nice and thin. does the nicest little lines. Just exactly where I want them because there's only a few bristles left on this brush. It's a really old brush. I've just cut off most of the bristles. A few more up high. For some reason you can see the ones on this side too. Just the way the tree is shaped. There's actually some kind of vine or something down here. A bunch of leaves growing all around the trunk. So I'll put some of the highlighted leaves on right now. Put some more detail on in a minute. And I'm just go back, do a couple more strokes on that that ripple. Hopefully it'll come together now. A little bit too dark. It's amazing how one little tiny dark gray spot is kind of throwing off that ripple right there. But I think that's gonna have to do it right there. Might do a couple other little tiny little detail strokes off camera, but I don't want this video to go too long, so I'm going to leave it there for you right now, and I'll show you my results in a minute.
But first, here's a screenshot of the reference photo that you can print. I hope you have the courage and the chance to try it yourself. Here's my finished product. I hope you enjoyed watching me paint this reflective pond on mini canvas in black and white. It was super fun to do, and I have many more mini canvas paintings planned for the future. So I'll see you tomorrow with another mini canvas painting. Bye.